reconciling a QuickBooks online bank account to a bank statement helps ensure that your QuickBooks records match what your bank has. When the cleared balance in QuickBooks Online matches the ending balance on your statement, you're done, at least until the next statement comes in. We're going to head up to the top right and click the Settings icon. Underneath Tools, choose Reconcile. The first time you reconcile, you'll see this screen and it says Get Started. So I'm going to click that button and then I'm going to choose Let's Do It. And that takes us to the Reconcile an Account screen. The first thing you want to do is choose the account that you want to reconcile. So in this case, it's the checking account. Below that, you'll see the beginning balance, and ending date. When you reconcile, QuickBooks Online uses the ending balance from the last reconciliation as the beginning balance for the next one. When I created this account, I filled in the beginning balance, so that's what's showing here. It's $500. But as you reconcile, QuickBooks will always update it to use the ending balance from the last reconciliation. Now we have to fill in the ending balance from the physical bank statement and the ending date for that statement. After you do that, click Start Reconciling. That takes you to the Reconcile window. Above the table, you're going to see the beginning balance and the ending balance, but you'll also see the cleared balance. The reason that we have a cleared balance already is because we have downloaded transactions that we added, and those are already marked as cleared. You can see the number of payments and deposits that have been cleared to make up that cleared balance. Also, by the way, make sure that the beginning balance and ending balance do match what's on the statement. If it doesn't, you can click Edit Info up at the top right to make the changes. When you look at the table, you can see the transactions that have been cleared because over on the right-hand side, you'll see blue circles with white check marks. Also, above the table on the right side, we have an amount in the difference box. If it's not zero, we have to reconcile this difference. So we're going to look at the table. Everything in this table, it's just all the transactions are there. But there are buttons so that you can filter it to just show payments or just show deposits. Also, there's a filter applied automatically, and it says statement ending date. What this does is it hides transactions after the statement end date because they shouldn't appear on the statement. However, if you don't see a transaction from your statement, maybe it has the wrong date in QuickBooks Online, so you could click this X to turn off the filter. Well, let's go ahead and click Payments. That shows the payments in the table. To clear payments, I just go over to the right side and I click the circle to mark those as cleared. So I'm going to do that for all of them except for this refund check. Now we can go to the deposits. So I'm going to click the deposits button. What I see here are both deposits and if there are voided transactions, the amounts are zero, but they have to show up somewhere. So we're going to select those to mark those as cleared as well. And then I will select the other deposits. When I do that, I look up at the top and I hope that the difference is zero. In this case, it isn't. It turns out that the cleared balance is less than the ending balance. So when you think about that, what would make that happen? Well, a deposit would decrease this difference, and it would actually increase the cleared balance so it would match the ending balance. On the other hand, a payment would actually increase the difference and decrease the cleared balance. So maybe we actually missed a deposit. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go up and click Save for Later so I can save everything I've done so far. Now I'm going to go to the bank register. So I'm going to click the link at the top of the screen to see the register. And I remember, oh, that's right. I actually got a check from my insurance company. So let's go to the top left of the table, and I'm going to click the down arrow and choose deposit. So I'm going to add a deposit, and let's go ahead and let's say that this is for insurance. Now, if you don't have insurance as a vendor, you can just type it in and click save. But I've selected that, and the deposit is for the amount that was our difference. That was the missing transaction. Then I have to choose an account. Well, in this case, I'm actually not sure what I should use. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click Ask My Accountant. And then later on, I can do just that and fix the account. Then I'm going to go up to the top left and click these horizontal bars so I can collapse the navigation bar and see that Save button. So let's go ahead and click Save. I'm going to click cancel to hide that, and now we can go back to finish our reconciliation. Up at the top right of this screen, I can click reconcile, and that takes me back to the reconcile window. Now I'm going to click deposits, and there is the deposit from insurance. So I'm going to click that, and when I do that, the difference changes to zero, and you see this green circle with a white check mark. So I'm going to go ahead and click Finish Now. When I do that, I have two options. One, I can view a report of the reconciliation. In fact, it's a good idea to run that report, and then you could even print it to save it for your records. One last thing, I want to go back to the bank register. So I'm going to click the bank register link up above the report heading. Notice in this column that has a heading of a check mark, you'll see the letter R for any transactions that have been reconciled. And that's how you reconcile your bank accounts in QuickBooks Online.